A warehouse roof containing asbestos was damaged in a hailstorm. In 2019, the principal contractor hired a contractor to oversee these re-roofing works. The contractor hired a subcontractor through a labour hire company to carry out the work. On the day of the incident, the workers hired by the subcontractor completed the re-roofing tasks set out for that day. The workers asked if there were any other tasks to carry out. It was suggested by another subcontractor that they could begin dismantling the edge protection surrounding the roof. The workers began dismantling the handrails, which were made of steel. High voltage power lines were located only 2.4 metres from the rear of the building. One worker began sliding a 6-metre long handrail out of its brackets towards the end of the roof. The worker was holding the handrail when an electrical arc flash occurred between the power line and the handrail. The handrail made physical contact with the power line while the worker was holding it. The worker holding the handrail was electrocuted and fell onto the roof. The second worker tried to help by kicking the handrail out of the first worker's hands. There was an explosion, and the second worker received serious electrical flash burns to his legs. Tragically, the first worker died on site from his injuries. Other building site workers had no option but to jump down onto a lower roof of the building for safety. They waited on a brick wall until they could be rescued by emergency services. Before work began, an independent scope of works report was provided to the principal contractor as part of the tender process. The report identified the power lines as a safety hazard and stated that they would need to be de-energised before work started. This didn't happen. The contractor completed a site-specific safe work method statement for this re-roofing work. The statement was reviewed and approved by the principal contractor, but it did not identify nearby power lines as a safety hazard. Workers on site raised concerns about the close proximity of the power lines with the site manager. These concerns were not addressed by the principal contractor, and measures to de-energise the power lines were not taken. The workers on site did not receive training or instruction on proper procedures when working near overhead power lines. The contractor that had installed the edge protection did not ask the workers to dismantle the edge protection surrounding the roof. An investigation into the incident identified that the principal contractor failed to identify that overhead power lines were in close proximity to the work area as outlined in the independent scope of works report. Ensure the power lines were de-energised before work started. Verify that the safe work method statement provided by the contractor properly identified the hazards and risks associated with power lines, and act upon control measures to address the hazards and risks. The investigation also identified that the contractor failed to identify power lines as a hazard in the safe work method statement, assess the height and the distance of the power lines from the work area, identify the hazards and risks involved in erecting and dismantling edge protection on the roof, including the distance between the installed edge protection and power lines, identify the risk of steel handrails coming into contact with or in close proximity to power lines, confirm with the principal contractor that the power lines had been de-energised prior to work starting. The subcontractor failed to prevent workers from erecting and dismantling the edge protection on the roof and handling equipment or material that conducts electricity within 4 metres of the energised power lines. Work carried out on or near energised electrical mains, services or equipment is high-risk work. If there are power lines on or near the worksite, it's vital to ensure that risk assessments are conducted prior to the work commencing. A safe work method statement addresses the hazards and risks associated with working near power lines. Local electrical supply authorities are consulted and safety requirements are met before any work starts on or near power lines. Power lines are de-energised and control measures are implemented. A minimum 4 metre distance is maintained between workers and power lines when handling steel rods and other long metal items. And workers are trained and instructed on proper procedures when working near overhead power lines. This video was produced by the offender as a result of a district court order to raise awareness of work health and safety. It was developed in consultation with Safe Work New South Wales.